This Friday marks the first day of the Stowe Weekend of Hope for cancer survivors, caregivers, and their families. It'll be held virtually for the second year in a row. Local 22's Dana Casullo has more now on this year's event. Dana?
Lauren, three different cancer survivors told me what the Stowe Weekend of Hope means to them.
The Stowe Weekend of Hope offers educational and inspirational opportunities for people experiencing cancer, cancer survivors, caregivers, and families.
For many of us, it's a big struggle, but yet we realize, wait a minute, we're not alone. There's people that are going through the same struggle.
This year, they'll have more than 40 online workshops.
We meet other people when we're going through the cancer diagnosis and treatment. But when we meet people in this kind of connection, there's this energy, there's this sort of lifting that happens.
The weekend also offers support mechanisms for healing, comfort, and spiritual enlightenment. Ray Carter was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2018 and is now cancer-free.
People that go through cancer will say, you know, it is a mind, body, and spirit experience. And so I think it's really important for us to be treating all of those aspects.
She's helping to run a workshop on nurturing the mind, body, spirit, and connection.
Working from our own stories and situations, and then leading people in mindfulness work and embodiment practices and a visualization and self-massage techniques.
Tim Cavanaugh was diagnosed with stage 2 colorectal cancer in 2015. He's also now cancer-free. He's a past keynote speaker and continues to attend the event.
We really need to do more on a preventive basis and make people aware of not only the type of cancer that I have, but other cancers that people are going through.
Tim tries to lift people up with humor.
And I literally do it through my own experience, but it's totally relatable to anyone in the room, whether they're going through cancer themselves or they're not going through cancer.
And even though the event is virtual, it still brings everyone together.
It takes a village to get someone through cancer. And we all need to help lift.
If you are interested in registering, we will have a link on our website at mychamplainvalley.com. Reporting live in the studio, Dana Casullo, Local 22 News.